Hello and welcome to the first episode of our Mazda BT50 Build. Now this is going to be quite a similar exercise to what we did with the Isuzu D-Max in that we are going to take you through, review the vehicle and show you a list of the HSP products as well as some partner products that we'll be putting onto this car over the next couple of months and really taking you through an in-depth viewing of how we're going to build this car, why we're doing what we're doing. We're going to take you through, show you the product development. We're going to show you the new products as they get released. You'll have exclusive viewing into why we're making it, how we're making it, who we're making it for, as well as a lot of the cosmetic upgrades that are really going to make this BT50 stand out from the crowd. Now, this is the third generation of the Mazda BT50. The previous generation was a collaboration between Ford and Mazda, and now they have moved away and gone with Isuzu as a collaboration on the vehicle. Now with the last BT50, there was quite a lot of comparisons made between the Ford Ranger and the Mazda BT50. Essentially, they were quite a similar vehicle in the first series when it was launched around 2011. Now Ford had a lot of upgrades after they released the Mark II and Mark III, which Mazda did not carry on to their following vehicles as well. This is why over the last couple of years, you've seen a decline in sales for Mazda BT50s as compared to the Ford Ranger, just because there was a lack in innovation and a lack of change in the actual vehicle. That's why I'm so glad that this particular vehicle has had a world of changes made to it. So in addition to the physical changes that you can see here, the Mazda BT50 has now got a Isuzu built engine, a much more redefined interior. It handles much better, it drives much better. The interior is very, very intuitive as well as being quite easy to use. Apple Wireless CarPlay, a lot of other features as well. So I'd love to take you guys through this vehicle and kind of show you exactly what those changes are. So as I mentioned, it went from quite a bold design to something that is a little bit more individual to Mazda and something that in my opinion is a lot more of a European looking vehicle. I love the current sleek Mazda look and I'm very glad that the CX-8 kind of look carried over to the new BT50. It looks awesome from the front. And I think it's definitely ahead of its time in terms of its design. Now, what we have here is the top spec GT version of the BT50. This is in the dual cab variation. Unlike the previous model BT50s, the dual cab is only available with a tub. You cannot get a freestyle tub variation. It would have to be a cab chassis. So that's quite a big change because traditionally there was quite a lot of Mazda BT50s in the freestyle version sold. The tub height is quite generous. You've got 1571 in length, 1530 in width, and you've got a 490mm depth in the tub itself. Between the wheel arches, you're looking at 1120mm. There's also four tight end points in the tub, two being on the rear, two being towards the front. Engine-wise, there's definitely been an improvement. We've got a four-cylinder, 3-litre turbo diesel engine pushing out 450 newton meters of torque and 140 kilowatts of power. The transmission is a 6-speed manual or auto transmission. And I have been driving this vehicle for the better part of a week, and I can definitely say that there is massive improvements against the last BT50, as well as if you compare it to any of the other utes on the market, it's definitely one of the top performers when it comes to road comfort, road convenience, as well as just in general drive comfort as well. I think the interior of the BT50 really, really stands out across a lot of utes in the market. You've got heaps of storage space, so you've got one, two, and some coin holders here, as well as a glove box in the middle. I think the more brownish leather interior is quite individual, and I think it looks really nice. I love the detail on the stitching here. Accessibility is really simple. So you've got wireless Apple CarPlay, which just makes life much easier. So you've got your Apple Maps or Google Maps, whatever you like to use, and a range of other applications that are on your phone, which will cross over to this. A very simple to use heating and cooling sort of system with dual climate as well. You've got a USB point here, 12 volt here, and you do have heated seats in the GT version, which is a really nice little addition as well. In terms of airbags, you've got an eight airbags, so for safety, it's definitely one of the best performers on the market, and it does have a center airbag as well. Similar to the Isuzu D-Max, it does also have the emergency braking, autonomous high beam, blind spot monitoring, cycle detection, lane departure warning, and a heap of other features, including front and rear sensors as well, which is a great addition to the Mazda BT50. Now, there's a lot of reviews out there that are kind of pointing out the fact that the BT50 and the Isuzu D-Max are almost identical of a car. And while that is true, I think there are some clear separations between the two vehicles, which I want to go through. One of the differences is, as you can see, the visuals of the vehicle. So the front end, as I mentioned, is quite European in its design. I think it looks really nice. I think it's done a great job at having that Mazda sort of a feel to it. And I think dressing up this car with some bigger wheels, some flares, and obviously a bunch of HSP sort of gear is gonna make it look really, really nice. Another difference is the Mazda BT50 does have a higher recommended retail price as compared to the Isuzu D-Max. And a lot of people wonder what they're going to get for that extra. Now, while there is differences between the two brands and how they price vehicles, there is a couple other differences that does narrow the gap slightly. One of those differences is Mazda does not charge any extra for metallic paint, whilst Isuzu does charge a $500 extra. So just assume that if you are getting a metallic finish, then there will be that $500 savings there. Another difference as well is that on the highest and second highest model, you do have the passive entry, which is something that only comes on the X-Terrain Isuzu D-Max. The Mazda BT50 GT version also does have heated seats. Now, while this is really just a convenience thing, it does make a little bit of a difference when you're getting to your job site early in the morning in winter. In saying that though, that's the main differences between the two vehicles. I do think that the Isuzu D-Max is a phenomenal vehicle. We've been driving it for about a month now and we have no faults with it at all. The Mazda BT50 follows a similar sort of a vehicle and I think it'll definitely be a great seller. When you're comparing the two vehicles against each other, you're not gonna find much differences, but when you are comparing the Mazda BT50 against some of the other vehicles on the market, it does have some really, really good advantages. Now you get a whole lot of car, but you don't really get any accessories with this vehicle, which is a good and bad thing because you can customize it exactly how you want it. HSP, through us, we will be doing HSP tailgate central locking, HSP tail assist, HSP silverback, HSP electric roll R cover, HSP load slide, and of course the HSP premium hard lid. All of those will be getting released via these videos. We'll be giving you updates on the release dates, on the development work that goes behind them, as well as how they're going to be fitted and how they're going to look on the vehicle and pricing as well on those. So that's a really exciting thing that's going to be part of these videos. So please stay tuned to all of our Mazda BT50 videos that you'll see across the build. All of our products are Australian made, so you will be seeing the development work that goes behind all of these products. You'll be seeing the engineering work that goes behind it, the fittings, the test runs, the final products, all live with these videos. So please stay tuned and follow the Mazda BT50 build series. And if you are interested in any of the other build series that we're doing, we're currently running the Isuzu D-Max and we will have a couple of more coming out soon as well. Before we wrap this video up, I would love to give a big shout out to Pakenham Mazda, who did help us source the vehicle and they did an excellent job on the pricing as well. So a massive shout out to them. Thank you so much for helping us out with that. For more information on HSP products, on the BT50 build, you can follow us on social media, which is at HSP4X4. That's on Facebook, YouTube, and Instagram. Or you can visit us on www.hsputelids.com, and I look forward to seeing you on the second edition of the Mazda BT50 build.